Hey guys, you're now part of an experiment and you can't leave this video. This experiment was done at the Harvard Business School and is also mentioned in the book, 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. Watch this picture for 5 seconds. Now watch this other picture and write down somewhere what you see in it. You can even pause the screen if you want. Now if I tell you to see the same picture and find an old lady in it. Let me help you out here. Let's see this third picture and now see the main picture to find where the old lady is. Found it, right? This experiment was done at HBS where half the class was given the picture of the young lady and the other half of the old lady. Then the main picture was shown and both the halves were told to describe the main picture. Then what? Both the halves went into a fierce debate where each one of them went about explaining their version of the lady. One person said, "Hey, that's a young lady whom I would take out for a date." Whereas the other one said, "No ways, man, that's an old lady who's wearing a cloth over her head." At the end of the debate, all three pictures were shown to the class to conclude that both the parties had different perspectives and both were right. The class could not come out of their conditioned selves of having seen the former pictures and they were stuck with their perceptions, hence making themselves right and the other person wrong. We have been influenced by so many things, our family, our culture, tradition, schooling, and so many other things, and that creates a version of our events. But that does not mean that someone else's version to something might be incorrect. For example, let's say you're driving a car and the red light turns green. All the cars start moving except the car right in front of you. Naturally, you start honking without knowing the reason why the car in front of you is not moving. It could be that the car is facing a technical glitch, or let's say a bike might have met with an accident right in front of the car, or the car in front of the car might not be moving. But we are not ready to see the perspective of the car right in front of us, and that is where lies the problem. Hence, let's make the effort to see the other person's perspective, be it our parents, our friends, relatives, or any other person. And if all human beings are able to do that, then we can genuinely make peace, not war.
Guys, thank you for watching my perspective on perspectives and tag 3 friends in the comment section below so they too can take this experiment. Thank you for watching. Do like, share and subscribe my page.